إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وَخَيْرُ الْهَدِي هَدْيُ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ Every going astray and every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدٍ My dear brothers in Islam, as we approach the month of Ramadan, And we ask Allah to allow us to see that month, to reap its rewards, to make istighfar, to remember Allah with dhikr and praying and reciting the book of Allah, the speech of Allah. We remind ourselves with the statement of Amr ibn Qais, radiallahu rahimahullah, where he said, طُوبَ لِمَنْ أَصْلَحَ نَفْسَهُ قَبْلَ رَمَضَانَ He said, glad tidings for the one who rectified himself before Ramadan. And the companions, radiallahu anhum waradahum, they used to prepare for Ramadan 5 months before it came. And here we are, less than 3 weeks. And if Allah allows us to live, we will see that month again. Yet there's still time to prepare so that you're not a Ramadan Muslim, or you don't only show up in Ramadan, or you don't only worship Allah in Ramadan. And in doing so, we remind ourselves with a hadith that in essence is like a guideline for the way the Muslims should live their life. So let us put the importance on what's summarized in this hadith. عن أبي مالك الحارث ابن عاصم الأشعري رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم التهور شطر الإيمان والحمد لله تملأ الميزان وسبحان الله والحمد لله تملان أو تملأ ما بين السماوات والأرض والصلاة نور والصدقة برهان والصبر ضياء والقرآن حجة لك أو عليك كل الناس يغدو فبايع نفسه فمعتقها أو موبقها رواه مسلم In this hadith on the authority of Abu Malik al-Harith ibn Asim al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him. He said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, purification is half your faith. And the phrase alhamdulillah, it will fill the scales. And subhanallah and alhamdulillah, they fill between everything that is between the heavens and the earth. Prayer is a light. Charity is a proof. Sabr, patience, is an illumination, it is a brightness. The Quran is either an argument for you or against you. And everyone goes out in the morning and sells himself, either freeing himself or destroying himself. This hadith, which we find in the Sahih of Muslim and other narrations, we see a comprehensive hadith covering purity, dhikr, Salah, charity, abiding by the Quran, patience, and how to live one's life. So let us understand this, because if we can implement this comprehensiveness, then we will, inshallah, be of those who reap the rewards of Ramadan and are on the straight path to earning Allah's mercy and forgiveness. The first part, At-Tahur Shatr al-Iman. At-Tahur, it is the act of purification. And we use water for that purification. And Shatr is half of something, but it doesn't necessarily have to mean equal halves. So the Tahur, it purifies the outside sins. Iman, it prevents the evil sins from inside. The shirk, the nifaq, the hypocrisy, the showing off and the like of this. So what is meant here? What is meant by this hadith is that purification could mean different things. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, مفتاح الجنة الصلاة ومفتاح الصلاة الوضوء. The Prophet ﷺ, he told us the key to prayer is wudu, is the afwan. The key to Jannah is the prayer. And the key to the prayer is your wudu. That you purify yourself according to the way the Prophet ﷺ did it. If you have questions, ask. But look for authentic sources. Because day in and day out, many of us see someone making the wudu in an incorrect order. Or not washing correctly. Or wiping where they should wash. Or washing where they should wipe. And the likes of these matters. So it's important. Iman sometimes is referred to as prayer. And prayer is only valid with purification, with the wudu. Allah said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ. Allah said, Allah will not ever allow your iman to be lost. But in this ayah, iman is referring to the prayers that they used to do to Bayt al-Maqdis in Jerusalem before the Qibla was changed to the Kaaba. So here we see the reference that because it's the key to prayer, it is half of your faith because the prayer is the key to Jannah. It could also mean freeing or purifying yourself from evil and sin. As Allah said of the people of Lut, what they said to Lut alayhi salam, إِنَّهُمْ أُنَاسٌ يَتَطَهَّرُونَ. They are indeed a people who want to be pure from sin. Iman, my brothers in Islam, is tasdiq al-qalb, it's the belief in the heart. وَالْقَوْلْ بِاللِّسَانِ, the statement of the tongue. وَالْعَمَلْ بِالْجَوَارِحِ, or الْعَمَالْ بِالْجَوَارِحِ, and the actions of the limbs. To do good deeds and stay away from sin. According to Ibn Rajab, Allahu A'lam, in this ayah, at-tuhur shatr, in this hadith, at-tuhur shatr al-iman, it refers to the wudu, the ritual purification with water. And this is the majority opinion. So we should be careful that we purify ourselves correctly when we approach the prayer. Walhamdulillahi tamla'u al-mizan. And praising Allah, it will fill the scales. Praising Allah with what He deserves. Getting hasanat on your scale. And here the scale, the mizan, is proved that on the Day of Judgment it will come forth. And it will weigh the deeds. You may say, how can an action be weighed? Allah is capable of everything. Deeds will be made into weighable forms. Alhamdulillah is praise and it is gratitude towards Allah, realizing the numerous blessings, the numerous provisions that Allah has given you. And this is a heavier phrase than just saying shukr. And here we remind the brothers who are still in salah when they come up and sami Allahu liman hamida, when the imam, or if you're reciting it, you say sami Allahu liman hamida. Many people say Rabbana walak alhamd and they add wa shukr. Alhamd encompasses all the thanks. Shukr is a phrase between us humans. Alhamd encompasses all praise and all thanks being to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, it is not from the sunnah to add wa shukr. So if you're doing it, you should leave it off because it is something that is not from the sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But there is something that is. The Prophet ﷺ, he was praying once and the companions were behind him. And when he came up from ruku' and he said, Sami Allahu liman hamida, Allah hears those who praise him. One of the companions behind him was heard saying, Rabbana wa lakal hamd hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fee. To Allah is all praise. To Allah is all praise, abundant, good, blessed, sufficient. Praise. After the prayer, the Prophet ﷺ said, who said this? The companion said, his name is not mentioned here. He said, it was me. So the Prophet ﷺ, he said, رَأَيْتُ بِدْعَةً وَثَلَاثِينَ مَلَكًا يَبْتَدِرُونَهَا أَيُّهُمْ يَكْتُبُهَا أَوَّلْ. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, I saw 30-some angels rushing to write down Who would be the first one to write down that you said this phrase? So this was from the Sunnah, such a great reward. Angels rushing to write your name down for saying it. Yet we have many leaving off. Hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fee. After saying Rabbana wa lakal hamd, or after saying Alhamdulillah when they sneeze and the likes, which is actually from the Sunnah, and resorting to something not from the Sunnah by adding wa shukr. So Alhamdulillah has a heavier meaning than shukr, than thankfulness. Allah says, وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ فَلَا تُظْلَمُ نَفْسٌ شَيْئًا. Allah says what means, and we shall set up the balances of justice on the day of resurrection, then none will be dealt with unjustly in anything. And if there's a weight of a mustard seed of action or word or speech or good or bad, we will bring it. And sufficient are we to take account. So our actions, these statements will be weight on our scales on the day of judgment. وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ تَمْلَانَ أَوْ تَمْلَأُ مَا بَيْنَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And saying Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah, they fill what is between the heavens and the earth. This is the reward of them. Very simple statements. Subhanallah, you're denying that Allah has any blemish, that He has any defect, that He has any imperfection, that He is complete, and you are affirming that He is complete and perfect and not in need of anything else. This is with respect to his physical self and to his names and his attributes. Allah says, لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ مَثَلُ السُّوءِ وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Allah says what means, for those who disbelieve in the hereafter, there is an evil description. But for Allah is the highest and the loftiest of descriptions, and He is the Almighty, the All-Wise. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن سبحان الله العظيم وسبحان الله وبحمده. There are two statements, as our Prophet ﷺ said in this authentic hadith. There are two statements that are light on the tongue, heavy on the scales of reward, and we all need it, because we will never repay Allah for just the blessings and the provisions He's given us, not to mention the sins we do to wipe some of those out. There are two statements light on the tongue, heavy on the scales, beloved to the most merciful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah al-azim, to say subhanallah al-azim, that Allah is high, above any imperfection or want, the great from every imperfection, and subhanallah wa bihamdih, that far above is Allah from every imperfection, and that I glorify and praise Him. And this hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. Very simple phrases. Subhanallah al-azim, subhanallah wa bihamdih. And the reward can fill what is in the heavens and the earth. Look up. You can reach only so high. You can fly only so high. These phrases fill their abundance, their weight, their special weight with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fills the heavens and the earth. The following hadith indicates the superiority of this dhikr. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, أَلَا أُخَبِّرُكُمْ بِخَيْرِ أَعْمَالِكُمْ وَأَرْفَعِهَا فِي دَرَجَاتِكُمْ وَأَزْكَاهَا عِنْدَ مَلِيكِكُمْ وَخَيْرٍ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِعْطَاءِ الذَّهَبِ وَالْوَرَقِ وَخَيْرٍ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْ تَلْقُوا عُدُوَّكُمْ فَتَضْرِبُوا أَعْنَاقَهُمْ وَيَضْرِبُوا أَعْنَاقَكُمْ. قَالُوا بَلَى. قَالَ ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. The Prophet ﷺ, he highlighted dhikr as a whole, especially these phrases we mentioned in this hadith. He said, shall I not inform you of the best of your deeds, the one that will raise you in ranks, the one most purifying to your Lord, which is better for you than giving gold and silver in charity, and better for you than meeting your enemy, and you striking their neck and them striking your neck. They said, certainly tell us, O Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, it is the remembrance of Allah, dhikr Allah ta'ala. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said about dhikr, about the remembrance of Allah, especially with these phrases, subhanallah al-azim, subhanallah wa bihamdi, and the likes of them, that it is food for the heart. It's the weapon with which you fight. It is the cure for any disease. And it is the connection between the servant and his Lord. This is the weight of that dhikr we have. Yet many times our idle time in the car, in the bed, sitting amongst friends, whatever it is spent listening to forbidden things from music and the likes of it, or spent in idle talk, not remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make us of those who remember Him with Alhamdulillah and Subhanallah, and make it heavy on our scales, and make us of those who purify ourselves for Him. أَقُولُ قَلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرَ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ إِذَا اللَّهَ يَغْفِرَ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in this hadith, we're reviewing الطهور شطر الإيمان. Purification is half of faith. والحمد لله تملأ الميزان. الحمد لله, it fills the scales that we all will be, have our deeds weighed on the day of judgment. وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ تَمْلَأُ أَوْ تَمْلَأُ مَا بَيْنَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Subhanallah and Alhamdulillah, they fill what is between the heavens and the earth. The next part, and we'll break this hadith into 2 weeks, the next part is وَالصَّلَاةُ نُورٌ. That salah is a light. In this case, it's the nur like the moon. وَالصَّلَاةُ نُورٌ. The light that illuminates for one to guide them on a path to the hereafter. The most important pillar for the one who enters Islam by their shahada. We know the hadith where the Prophet ﷺ said, "Al-amr عندنا الصلاة وعموده الأمر عندنا الإسلام وعموده الصلاة." The situation that concerns us is Islam, and its pillar. The Prophet ﷺ said, "The pillar of Islam is that salah. It is the first thing we'll be asked about on the day of judgment." إِنَّ أَوَّلَ مَا يُحَاسَبْ بِهِ الْعَبْدِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ عَمَلِهِ صَلَاتِهِ. That the slave, the first thing he will be questioned about on the day of resurrection from his actions will be about his or her salah. This salah being a light, it is a guiding light. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. It is the prayer, verily, that prevents one from great sins and wicked deeds. Very often someone tells me, when we tell them, come to the masjid, ya akhi, come pray. Start your prayers, even if it's at home. And they'll say, I need to get rid of doing some things I'm doing. And then I'll come, I feel like a hypocrite. This is shaitan. Shaitan is whispering to you. It is establishing that prayer that's going to help you leave off any wickedness, any evil that you're doing. Never cut off the prayer. Because that's your connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never cut it off. Even if you're doing every major sin in the book, pray and try and make it sincere and beg Allah to help you stop the evil you're doing. Salah is a physical light. On the day of resurrection, for the one who performed them, Allah says, يَوْمَ تَرَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَسْعَى نُورُهُمْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ. Allah says in Surah Al-Hadid, what means, on the day of resurrection, you'll see the believing men and the believing women, their light running forward before them and by their right hands. That light emanating from them, يوم القيامة. Why? Because they established their prayers, the five at a minimum in their day, the five fard obligatory prayers. Remember, it was going to be 50. And Allah reduced it at the Prophet Muhammad's request. So this is a physical light, يوم القيامة, a day of fear, a day of worry, anxiety, grief, because of you having to be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with what you did in this life. But you can have that light emanating from you. You'll know the people who used to pray. And it could be a physical light in this life, not in the hereafter. The faces of those who pray have a light to them. سِيْمَاهُمْ فِي وَجُوهِهِمْ مِنْ أَثَرِ السُّجُودِ. Allah says what means their mark of faith is on their faces, from their traces of their sajda, of their prostrations during their prayers. This is not the mark some people see on the forehead. There's disbelievers with the same mark here. That is not the mark being referenced. This is a light that emanates from a person because of the sujood they do. And yet, what do we see many times? Someone making sajda like they're pecking their head on the ground. Someone making sajda, and you watch them and you try and say Subhana Rabbi al-A'la one time. You don't even get past Subhana and they're up already. How did they say it? Where's the khushu'? The Prophet said, make sajda till you are sure that your body bones have settled and you are fully in sajda. Stop rushing the prayer. Because this sajda is a light in this life and the next life, and a guiding light in this life for those who perform it. What is important, my brothers in Islam, is how important and great the prayer is spiritually, in this life and the hereafter. As-salatu nur, the prayer is a light. And we ask Allah to grant us that light from our foreheads in this life and the next, and allow the salah to guide us away from evil and sin that we may be doing. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka anta sami'un qareeb mujib ad da'awat ya muqallib al qulub thabbit qulubana ala dinik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit qulubana ala dinik يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.